at age 19, I found myself in front of 316 year-olds and I was speaking. Within a couple minutes, half the girls were crying. Then one girl in the middle of the room started weeping. She put up her hand and she said, "I'm so sorry to interrupt, but can I come up there and give you a hug?" She came up and she hugged me and she cried on my shoulder and she said, "Thank you, thank you, thank you. No one's ever told me that they love me and no one's ever told me that I'm beautiful the way that I am." And that's when I knew I was born to be a speaker.
So he came to me, he unwrapped me, he looked at me, wrapped me back up, went back to my mum and said, "He's beautiful."
Nick has now taken his message of hope to a staggering 57 countries and an audience of hundreds of millions, including 13 presidents. And now he has company on his travels. In 2012, he married Kanye, and they're expecting their second child this summer.
And we want to just share our story with everyone, my wife and I, because we've come across a lot of people who are not happy, who have given up on themselves and given up on love. And we want them to not give up. I look at the world that we live in and all the pain, and I say, without heaven, what do we have? It's not a coping mechanism, but everything starts making more sense when our eyes are fixed on eternity. I don't need arms and legs for 90 years because arms and legs are probably going to give me arthritis later on anyway. But when you don't get a miracle, you can still be a miracle for someone else.
It's there in the newborn cry, there in the light of every sunrise, there in the shadows of this life, your great grace. It's there on the mountain top, sorrow and the dancing, your great grace, oh such grace. From the creation to the cross, there from the cross into eternity, your grace finds me. Yes, your
It's great to be here on Tyneside with the beautiful Sage Gateshead glistening just behind me. We were actually here last summer filming a Junior Songs of Praise just over there. It was a day full of fun, and here's a little reminder to get you in the summer spirit. On Songs of Praise, we feature some great performers. Time now to meet another one. David Grant has been speaking to Nashville-based award-winning singer-songwriter Jen Bostick.
Jen's Christian faith is a big inspiration behind her songwriting. Although she first made it big in America, Jen's now in demand all over the world, including here in the UK, where she's on tour.
This is not your first trip to London, is it?
This is not. I believe this is my 10th in the last 3 years.
What was the first one like?
So overwhelming. I found out a week before I was leaving that I was coming over here, and it was such a step of faith to say, all right, I'm going to hop on this plane, I'm going to figure out where I'm staying kind of as I go. And it was wonderful, though. And I think sometimes when you just push a little bit past your comfort zone, amazing things can happen.
Now, your breakthrough song happened just a few years ago. Tell us about that. Tell us the story behind it.
It's a song called Jealous of the Angels, and I wrote it for my dad who passed away when I was 10 years old in a car accident.
There will be another angel around the throne tonight.
He was the first person to ever encourage me to play music and inspire me in that way. And after I lost him, it was the one thing that I felt like I could still connect with him through.
Only God knows why.
It was amazing the way people started to connect with it, because I thought the song was too personal. But to see people be comforted by the story and the song was so humbling. And to know that the Lord's working in that and using it in such a powerful way, it just kind of lets my dad's memory live on.
I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight.
Do you feel as though your faith plays a big part in the motivation for making music or wanting to touch people?
I would say the biggest part, for sure, yeah. I mean, I wouldn't have a voice or the talents that I have if God hadn't given them to me. So I feel very blessed to be able to do this for a living and just to be able to connect with people.
We invited Jen to St Sepulchre's without Newgate in central London. The church is known as the National Musicians Church.
There's something so magical just about being in the Lord's house, and the history here is incredible. We don't obviously have churches this old in America, and so being able to come over and just be in this beautiful space and just share in such a holy place is great.
Tell me about the song that you're singing for us today.
The song that I'm singing is called Little Grace, and there is so much unfortunate judgment in this world, and the song is just about showing grace. I mean, the Lord shows us grace minute by minute, and if we could share that same grace and show that same grace to one another, I think this world would be such a happier place.